Melania Trump claims Dukes are slowly poisoning her husband Donald Trump, according to a fake news story. Gossip Cop can expose this article as both unsubstantiated and inaccurate. We can also explain how it came about. This week, President Trump appeared to slur his words while giving a speech, leading the White House to announce he'll soon undergo a medical exam. Because of that, your newswire was apparently inspired to manufacture an article alleging the First Lady believes her husband's speech trouble is the result of poisoning. The story begins, First Lady Melania Trump claims there is a secret poisoner in the White House and fears her husband is being slowly poisoned with heavy sedatives smuggled into his drinks in an attempt to slow him down, control him, and discredit his presidency, according to reports. While reports are cited in that introductory sentence, no specific reports are actually named and Gossip Cop could find no reputable publications peddling such information. But the site insists, while public debate rages about Donald Trump's health, Melania has told friends and associates that the once robust and high-energy man she knew and loved has been replaced with a slower, damaged version. She is quoted as supposedly saying, by 8 p.m. he is slurring. This is not the man I know. Of course, the speech that received so much attention this week took place long before 8 p.m. Still, the webloid goes on to claim Melania believed that a tap in the White House that provides the president Coca-Cola has been contaminated, leading her to supposedly insist he stop drinking from the tap and instead revert to drinking from cans she brings herself, among fears the active campaign to poison the president is a high-level operation. It's further alleged she has been warned by senior intelligence agency staff that former President George W. Bush was reduced to a brain-damaged state after years of steady poisoning. That claim, of course, is nonsense. Whatever jokes have been made over the years about Bush's intelligence, he has not been left brain-damaged from poisoning, and no legitimate publication has ever made such an allegation. Both Laura Bush and Condoleezza Rice have separately recounted incidents in which they feared poisoning while abroad, but neither turned out to be conclusive, and Bush certainly wasn't subjected to steady poisoning that damaged his brain. Yet that's the problematic evidence your newswire is giving as proof that Melania is right to fear her husband is being poisoned. There's another hole towards the end of this story, when the online outlet maintains reporters from Time recently got a glimpse behind the scenes at the White House, where they reported on what goes down at the president's dinner table. The website contends Donald's meal was closely observed by Melania, who insisted on watching the chef prepare the meal with ingredients she provided herself to ensure he wasn't being poisoned. In actuality, the dinner referenced took place in May, not recently, and in the Times story, which was called Donald Trump After Hours, Melania was only mentioned a single time, and it was about her plans to move into the White House from New York City in about 4 weeks. That's right, while your newswire is using this dinner as evidence that the First Lady was monitoring her husband's food preparation, she wasn't even living with him at the time, let alone present for the meal. So, let's just recap what's going on here. This webloid claims Melania fears Dukes are slowly poisoning Donald, yet no legitimate publication has reported anything similar. The site asserts the president starts slurring by 8 p.m. Yet the speech that prompted this story took place during the day. It's further alleged former President Bush was regularly poisoned and left brain damaged, but that also hasn't been legitimately reported elsewhere. Lastly, it's asserted Donald recently had a dinner with Time reporters where Melania was observing the preparation when A. the meal took place more than 6 months ago and B. the First Lady was not there at the time. In other words, none of this actually holds up. When examined closely, it becomes apparent this is just a shoddily concocted story from the same outlet that routinely publishes outrageous fake news, including an article just days ago that falsely claimed Denzel Washington called Barack Obama the criminal-in-chief at a screening for his latest movie. Just like with this report about the Trumps, that allegation could be found nowhere but on your newswire. That's because it's all made up.